We're the Taylor Scott Band, playing on the Denver Loft Sessions right here, right now. Thank you.
John Wirtz. I play keyboards. I'm from West Concord, Ohio, just outside of Cleveland.
My name is Lem Williams. I'm from Denver, Colorado. I play drums.
My name is Todd Edmonds. I'm from Augusta, Georgia, and I play the bass and the tuba and the bass harmonica.
Taylor Scott. I'm originally from St. Louis, Missouri, but I grew up mostly in Wyoming. Now I live here in Denver. I play the guitar, I sing, and write songs.
I played the tuba in middle school, and my band director was a jazz drummer, so I took the upright bass home and figured it out. And then electric bass later, but the tuba and upright bass first.
I got started when I was 8 years old. My parents didn't know what to get me for my birthday, so they just got me a keyboard, and I started picking stuff up by ear pretty quick, and they got me into lessons shortly after that.
Growing up around the house, my parents were playing, I guess, like the country music of the day and things like that. The first thing that I fell in love with was rock and roll. First record I bought was AC/DC Live. And so it's diversified a lot since then, but when I was 8 or 9, that was the thing.
Salt on my watermelon, and I like the smell of rain. I wouldn't mind having my heart broken, but I can't stand the pain. I make my castles out of mud, and I make pies in the sand. And I think the snow and the sun, they go. Thing I do, and everyone think I'm crazy. I like that too. Don't really go for romantic movies, but a breeze can make me cry. Sit in my car with the windows open just to watch the people walk by. Buy myself a pair of shoes that don't really fit, so I can walk my way to Mississippi and hang out for a bit. You think I got a lot of crazy stories, almost everyone is true. Claim to be no wisecracker, I just
fun. With a little bit of satisfaction, yeah, when the day's done, you say you're marching to the beat of your own drums. Well, I prefer to dance.
My mom just on her way home, she saw a yard sale and saw this like really like raggedy, horrible kit that I actually still have. And she brought it home and threw it together, and I jumped on it and started playing. And she, you know, she asked me, you know, how do I know what I'm doing? And I was just playing. I said, I don't know. And I kept going. And the next day she took it to my grandfather's church, and I've been playing ever since.
When you're at Red Rocks for a hike or a concert, did you know you can do your part to keep one of Denver's favorite parks clean? Friends of Red Rocks is a large volunteer organization that cleans up the park monthly and during shows. They do their cleanup thing on the last Saturday of each month and meet in the south lot. Go online for more info. And remember, when you're at the Rocks this year, partying at Shakedown Street in the south lot, or tossing a football and bumping the bass in the north, please pick up after yourself. If you enjoy the arts, which are a big part of civic life, then stay informed on other civic things by watching award-winning local TV programs and city council meetings live and on demand every day on Denver 8 TV. Is your main mode of transportation around town two wheels rather than four? City Council and the mayor have made bicycling and pedestrian infrastructure a large budget priority for 2014. The mayor's Bicycle Advisory Committee meets every month, and you can have your say about biking issues in our city at these meetings. Wheel on over to denvergov.org for more information.
We call it Soul Jam just because the way I started the band was I was really, really listening to and writing a lot of soul music. And this was a few years ago, but I'm also a lead guitar player. So in soul music, traditionally, that's not the key instrument. So I just came up with this Soul Jam concept of it's kind of soul and funk music that stretches out a little bit.
There's some great jazz musicians in town, young people playing really good stuff.
There's a lot of talent that's the scene knows about, but you know, a lot of other people don't. And just every time you turn around, there's like 20-year-olds that are coming up that you're just so impressed with where they're at age 20 that, you know, kind of reminds you to step your own game up, you know, to keep up with the whole scene.
It's very diverse, which is cool. There's a lot of jazz guys, there's indie rock bands, there's blues bands. I've seen a couple of cool country groups. The diversity is what's cool to me. There's a hip-hop scene here. I don't know. I like that it's not, you go to Denver to hear this kind of music. Obviously, there's a lot of bluegrass and jamgrass going on in Colorado in general. And I think that diversity is important. And I think it's really important when the music fans cross over from one to the other. Because, you know, you have your blues fans, jazz fans, rock fans, whatever. It's really, if I'm permitted to say so, the hippest ones cross those lines often.
I think there's a ton of just undiscovered talent. I think there's so many great keyboardists and drummers and bass players, guitarists, singers. There's so many, but it's just no one is really paying attention. They think that all we do here is ski, and we don't. There's a lot more to it, but people just aren't realizing it, and there's just a ton of it here. I wish they would actually do something, come out and just hang out in a lot of these places, because there's so much talent out here. It's unreal.
Nobody knows.
This is my favorite band to play with because everybody is so good. The first time I played with them, I mean, John he's got it so much going on, and he's so good. Taylor's so good. Everybody's just so good. They make you feel like you're a part of an all-star team, so you don't feel like, you know, you're on a team that can't produce. I feel like everybody can take the last shot, you know.
Denver music fans know how lucky we are to have the world-class concert venue Red Rocks right in our backyard. This season's concert schedule is filling up fast, so check online for when your favorite artists will be playing. Many of the same production pros that bring you the Denver Loft Sessions also produce another great show on Denver 8 TV, Red Rocks Premieres. Go online for more information and schedules for both shows, and be sure to check us out on Facebook and YouTube. So whether you're enjoying your favorite music outside at the Rocks or on your couch with Denver 8 TV, we'll keep you rocking all year long. If you enjoy the arts, which are a big part of civic life, then stay informed on other civic things by watching award-winning local TV programs and city council meetings live and on demand every day on Denver 8 TV. A lot of people see Denver as a sustainability champ, but we're actually lagging behind in our recycling efforts. We recycle less than 14% of the state and national averages. We can boost our recycling rate this year by recycling 2 more pounds a week, and it's easy to do. If everyone did it, we'd save over 150,000 barrels of oil, over 500,000 trees, and keep more than 57,000 tons of recyclables out of the landfill. Go online now to learn how and what to recycle to make your 2 extra pounds per week goal.
I would ask Kobe to play me, and he has no idea how to play drums at all, but I want him to play me.
Lim, of course. No.
Betty White.
Well, when the leaves fall off the tree, nobody questioned me. Things you miss for everything you see. Well, if the sky turns orange and red, nobody scratches their head. Oh, the sky turns orange and red, nobody scratches their head.
sun turned bright green, what would that mean? Well, when rain drop on the sky, things you miss for everything you see.
With their infectious blend of swing, folk, and original Americana music, Odessa Rose West easily captures the eyes and ears of local fans and swing dancers throughout the Front Range. Be sure to catch their warm and friendly sounds on the next Denver Loft Sessions.
Yeah.